Partitioning storage devices is something you should always consider, whether it is for your hard disk, flash drives, or any other drive. Hello everyone, welcome to Design Algorithm. I am Shelly, and today we are going to learn how to partition a hard disk. But before getting into the actual process, let's find out why we need to partition storage devices. Partitioning a disk can make it easier to organize files such as videos and photo libraries, especially if you have a large hard drive. Creating a separate partition for your system files can also help protect system data from corruption, since each partition has its own file system. Partitioning allows you to maximize your storage and keep your files safe. Partitioning allows you to use multiple file systems. While you may not have use for multiple file system in your internal drive, you can apply this to your external drives. For example, you can split your 1 TB flash drive into sections, an XFAT or FAT32 or NTFS partition. This will allow it to work on Windows and Mac OS. Learn how to do it here. I have an external hard disk of around 1.5 TB disk space, and I am going to create partitions inside it. For that, I am going to type disk management in the search bar and choose create and format hard disk partitions. This is disk management system on my PC. Here you will see the disk volumes. This is the HDD drive. This one is SSD drive. This is my external disk of around 1.5 TB space. Right click on it and choose shrink volume. In this dialog box, you have to enter the amount of space you want to create a partition of, and you have to give that value in MB. I want to create a partition of 600 GB, so I will type 6 followed by 5 zeros and then hit shrink. The primary partition shrunk and an unallocated partition of approximately 585 GB is created, as you can see on my screen. Now we will right click on this unallocated partition and choose new simple volume. In the dialog box that appears, you have to click next. In this dialog box, you have to specify the volume size that you want to create. In my case, I am going to create a 300 GB volume, and again the value has to be in MB. Click next. Here you can assign a drive letter if you want and then hit next. In the next window, you can assign a name to the new volume if you want and hit next and then hit finish. And you can see that a new volume is created with the name that I gave. And now I am left with around 300 GB unallocated partition. I am going to right click on it and choose new simple volume. I will repeat the same steps as I did before. We'll specify the volume size in MB. Choose a name for volume and hit next and finish. And another volume is created. Now I will convert the remaining unallocated space into another volume. I will right click on it and choose new simple volume. Repeat the steps. Here if I accept this value, then the unallocated space will be converted into a new volume. Or I can give a value if I want. Suppose if I give some value and follow the steps. You will see that another volume is created and I am left with some free space. What I can do now is, I can add this to my new volume that I created. For that, I will right click on this new volume and choose extend volume. Hit next and finish. The free space will be added in the volume. The process of disk partitioning is complete. Hope you find it useful. And in case you are not able to follow the steps or confused, you can comment below. I will try to help you with your queries. And if you find this video useful and want to see videos like this one, you can hit the like button and subscribe to my channel, as I am uploading new videos every week. And also don't forget to press the bell icon so that you won't miss any new notification about upcoming videos on my channel. Thanks a lot.